pizza, isn't it? The next day, I just want to... I'm going to be a bit naughty now. Please forgive me, madam, if I'm being a bit cheeky now, sir. But I don't know if you heard about that guy in the newspaper, right? And there was a lady, and they were in this relationship for years and years and years, okay? And then they split up. Do you know what happened to the man? The lady dumped the man. Do you know what happened 1 month later? That man won £5 million in the lottery. Now there's something you're thinking of. Missed that gravy train, haven't I? You know, you're thinking, I could have had all those millions of pounds. You know, I think there'll be a lot of people that when they die, they'll wake up and they'll realise, I could have had eternal life with Jesus Christ. Do you believe that? What do you think of that? Do you think that eternal life is a real thing? Anyone wants to chip in, please do. I'm not the most important one. You're all of your opinions are valid, but he says that, you know, I think we'll wake up and we'll be like,
yeah.
About eternal life in Jesus Christ. Who's Logan Paul? Anybody going by know who Logan Paul is? Yeah, if I did this, would you know who Logan Paul is? Anybody know who I'm talking about there? Now, Logan Paul, at the beginning of this year, he got in a lot of trouble. Have you heard of Logan Paul, sir? Yeah? He's a YouTuber, isn't he? And he got in a lot of trouble this year because he went to this forest and he laughed at people committing suicide. Wasn't that sad? I mean, that's very, very sad indeed that we've now got a society of young people and people that are laughing at serious things. Who watches Coronation Street here? Do any of you guys watch Coronation Street? No one would admit to that. A lot of people watch Coronation Street, don't they? You know? And I've got to admit, I don't want to upset anyone, but you know, I think it's a bit sad. We're watching Coronation Street, and it's all about people cheating on one another, people getting drunk, and that's what entertains us. We're getting a bit on the, you know, the sad side that, you know, we're getting entertained by those things. I'm going to put a bit of a strong challenge here. I don't want to upset anyone, but just think about this. We talked about Logan Paul and suicide. When your grandparents were teenagers, do you think the rate of suicide has increased or decreased? Over to you. When your grandparents, everyone think of your grandparents now. When they were teenagers, do you think the rate of suicide has increased or decreased? What do you think? There's a lot more suicides today. If you take God out of the picture and you go into a science lesson and you tell them you've come from slime, you've come from an accident, there's no meaning, there's no value, there's no purpose. Is there any reason why, you know, our young people are really lost? I'll tell you why I go a bit strong on this level. I used to work in a school, and every morning I'd drive to school every day and I'd see this girl at this bus stop just standing there. Pretty little thing, had the whole world at her fingertips. I found out 3 months ago that same girl committed suicide. And I can't help but think, did anyone tell her there was a God who loved her, who sent his son to die on a cross so that she could be saved, so she could have love and meaning and purpose? Why'd you say that, sir? Don't walk away. You've got to follow it up. Please follow it.
What has that got to do with it committing suicide?
How do you know he's a load of rubbish? I really appreciate what you said there. Thank you for that. Because I can understand why you're saying that. It's preach. I know, but I understand why you're saying that. Sir, would you stick around? I just want to say. I don't want to get into an argument, sir. I really don't want to get into an argument. But I think what you've said is a fair comment. There's a lot of people going by that say, you know, what's God got to do with it? My point was this.
No,
Craig said to me, you've got to prove the existence of God. So I'm going to ask you a question now, Craig, okay? And you guys answer it as well. What evidence would you like to see that would make you believe in God? Okay, let me ask you a question.
I believe in people. You're talking about something out here. Yeah, they believe it or not. something that nobody could I
don't believe
you. You don't believe either. Thank you, Maddie. No, I appreciate that. And I honestly think the majority of you going by wouldn't believe. I'll ask a question now for the atheists, okay? Right, very simple question now. What is zero plus zero? Someone answer that for me now. What's zero plus zero? Zero, okay? So if we've got no God, no creator, no designer, in the beginning there's nothing, how do we get a universe from nothing? That's the first question. So if any of the atheists, that's really...
I'm not a physicist and I'm not a thing of going to tell
you. You don't have to.
You.
That's what my first question is, okay? We look at that building there. How do we know that building once had a builder? Because the building itself is evidence of what's a builder. If I put a painting in front of you guys now and I say, who painted that painting? What's the evidence there was once a painter? Well, the painting itself.
Like split it completely. Why do you believe?
Because of that. That's exactly it.
Well, so you believe at this time, so why can't you give us the benefit of doubt and say, well, we don't, because the space was there at the beginning and it's been proven how it actually happened and how it got off. So our belief is just as strong as yours.
Sorry.
To do with the universe and all started up with the gases, the explosion, everything. We believe that happened.
Okay, so that's an interesting...
Which is something that's proven compared to what you're trying to say.
Craig, can I just say, if I've quoted you wrong, Craig, now, and anyone thinks I've misquoted you, you said to me that explosions and gases, that's what sort of made the universe, that's the physics.
As I said, I'm not...
Yeah, I know, neither am I, I'm not either, so I'm not pretending I'm any better. But my argument...
You prove me what you're saying is right. So you get all your stuff from a book that was written 1500 years ago. That's where you get your information from. 1500 years, the book, that basically goes across every religion going. Muslims believe exactly the same as what you believe. You both... preaching to the same God, Jews are preaching to the same God. So you've all come from one book. There's been proven. No, we won't go into that far. That's too complicated.
Okay, but let's just go. Let's take the first bit about explosions and gas. You asked me what my evidence is. So if we put an explosion, now I wouldn't do that. Please don't think I'm crazy, but if we put an explosion, a stick of dynamite in Marks and Spencer's, it's not going to cause nice things. Whenever I think of an explosion, I think of Hiroshima. I think it's September the 11th. That horrible thing, I have friends, I work with children, okay? And some of them were at that Ariana Grande concert. Whenever we think of explosions, we see mess and chaos. To say that this world came from an explosion, to me, I can't believe it. We've got friends, and they had a baby. I see there's a lovely little baby there. And my friend, he said...
Let me
finish my point,
Craig. The explosion for that was designed to destroy stuff. There's different, when you have an explosion, different things, different chemicals come out of the different ways you have it. You're just picking on one particular thing, which is what...
Craig, name me one explosion.
I can't, because I'm not a physicist and I'm not
going to... But I think even if you were a physicist, I don't think you could name any explosion which has ever caused any design from an explosion. I think it's
impossible.
You've all
been to school, you've all seen people when when you've been in your physics class, your chemistry classes, where they put different chemicals together and create something completely different. There's something from lab, from it's made you smile, it's different, it's not actually going to kill everybody, is it? It's the same sort of thing.
You're picking on stuff
and trying to get people saying, the explosion is the disaster, it's always going to be bad, so it can't be right. You're still not proving why you think
why God exists. Okay, I'll give you one more argument then, and then we'll move on, okay? Very important argument, okay? If I said to you that racism is wrong, okay? I'm going to be like, Walu, would you just come out here? This is my friend Walu, okay? I believe this man has got value, meaning and purpose, okay? Now, some people would be racist and say that that's wrong, would be against that. Is racism right or wrong?
It's wrong.
Wrong, isn't it?
Opinions.
So, why is it wrong, though?
Because that's the way we've been brought up and that's how we
okay. see
Okay,
so let's go to Nazi Germany, okay? Where
what's
they,
this got to do with...
What you said, please, Phil, please listen.
Every time I bring up a point, he seems to take you to what he wants to pull you to talk to.
Craig, I think you're not being fair. I would like to be a fair person, but would you let me finish...
You're a very good politician. You're taking the conversation where you want to talk.
I just with what? Can I finish? Is that fair?
Yeah,
can
we
finish now? Okay. So we go to Nazi Germany, okay, and they say that Jews are valuable and they're a race of society. So you said that morality comes from us as a collective. We were brought up a certain way, but the Nazis were brought up to murder Jews. How do we know it's wrong? Do you know?
Have
you heard
of the Nuremberg?
Have you heard of the Nuremberg?
Nazis weren't brought up to this. Just bear with me on this point. Nazis weren't brought up to murder Jews. One guy was brought up with that intention, and he used it as a political, let's say, stick to get the rest of his people to follow him.
But was it wrong what they did?
It was completely, utterly wrong with him, and don't get me wrong, I'm not racist in the slightest bit,
right.
But that's what he did. He was a good politician, and he was a good speaker. A bit like what this guy's doing.
Okay, great, so let me say this here. Let me get to my punchline, fine. The Nuremberg trials, okay? Many of you have heard of the Nuremberg trials. And the Nazi leaders, not just Hitler, well, Hitler was dead at that point, they stood up and they said, how can you in Britain say that we've done wrong being racist and we've killed these Jews? We just followed our own morality. We just did what we felt was right in our own culture. The chief prosecutor, a man called Robert Johnson, stood up and said, yes, but you know that's wrong because there's a law above the law. And the Bible says God has written the law upon man's heart by giving us all a conscience. Of course we know that racism is wrong. Of course we know murder is wrong because God has given us a conscience. And my argument to you would be is, how do you know the difference between right and wrong? Because if there is no God, there's no lawgiver, then equally, if I hit this man over the face, or I help this man, then it's equally just like a choice. Like, one man says he prefers broccoli, the other man says he prefers beans. Morality is just a choice, but we know it's not. And this is what I want to say.
Morality is a choice, you know it's not.
I'm saying morality, we know that morality is more than that. We know there is absolute right and wrong, because God has written it on our hearts. And let me ask you this now, Craig. I'm going to get a bit personal.
Morality to everybody here is completely different. Everybody will have their own thought of how they actually think it should be. Every country has its own thought. You've got Middle East thinking it's completely different from everybody over here. So who should say who's right and who's wrong?
Because ultimately, can you live it out? Are you a married man, Craig? Okay, have you got children?
Yeah.
Okay, if I hurt your children, and I say that my morality says I think it's fine for me to hurt your child, but you say that's wrong, how do you prove that I've done wrong? That's my point. And I just want
to
say, look, we can argue forever and ever. That's my point. But Craig, let me just ask you one thing. Have you done wrong before? Yeah, and I've done wrong, right? You see these fists here now, Craig? I know you might laugh at me, but do you think that these fists have ever hit anyone before? What do you think? Yeah? You think they have, okay? They have, actually. Do you think that these feet have ever walked to places maybe they shouldn't have?
Again, what you're trying to...
Do you think these eyes have looked at things they shouldn't have? What do you think?
Most people
have. Yeah, they have. But then ask me this, Craig, am I going to heaven?
Thank God, a minute. We've not even proved the existence of God yet.
Yeah, but I'm just going to... I just said we can argue and argue forever, and I'll have a chat with you in a minute. But I am going to heaven, not because of anything good I've done, because Jesus Christ came into this world, and that's why we're here this weekend. He bled and died on a cross. He took all of the wrong things you've done, all the wrong things I've done, and he was crushed on that cross. It says between the 6th and the 9th hour, darkness fell on the land. And between those 3 hours, Jesus cried with a loud voice, my God, why have you left me?
You've done it exactly again. You've gone down to saying to people that God exists, that we've gone to Jesus Christ. That's a completely different discussion, whether Jesus exists or whether God existed, or what Jesus actually was.
Would you like me to get a really intelligent person out to talk to you?
No, would you like me to bring a really intelligent person to bring across the
We agreed on that right and wrong conversation. Anyway,
we can talk forever,
but I'm just going to put one last challenge out, and I wonder if you'll be able to take this challenge. This is a hard challenge. Craig has given me a real grilling today, but I'm going to give one final challenge to Craig.
Which you don't answer any of the things I've said.
Okay, maybe not. We'll have a chat.
Which church do you actually represent? Are you a Jew?
No, I'm not. But can I, let me give you one last challenge.
Let's get it right. What church do you represent?
I'm a Christian. Okay, born again Christian. I'm a Baptist. I'm a Baptist. Born again. Okay. One last question to the crowd. So, what would you think of me now, Craig, if I said to you, Harry Potter's a terrible book? What would you think of me?
That's your opinion.
Okay. What if I said, Harry Potter is a load of rubbish, but I've never read it? Thank you, madam. Thank you for your question. You'd say, read it first and then make a judgment, yeah? So don't say the Bible's a load of rubbish without reading it. I'm going to offer you now a portion of the Bible, John's Gospel. If anyone wants it from mine, you're going to have to be brave now because people
watch
are
this.
A little bit. Would anyone like to take it from mine? Please take it and read it yourself.
Thank you. God bless. Thank you for your time. God bless, sir.
Thank you. Anyone else wants it? John's Gospel. Jesus said, I am the resurrection.
Why just John's? Why just John's? What about all the other four?
Well, there's plenty, but we're just giving.
Which all contradict each other, by the way.
Give me one contradiction then. I've
not got it in front of me, but I can't.
Well, there aren't any, sir. Give me one. Right. Name one contradiction, Craig.
I've not got it on me. I'll have to go. I'll have to come back.
Okay, you come back at 3 p.m. I'll tell you one thing. At
3 p.m,
folks, we've got a professor here who's going to take your questions. A scientist professor who is also a Christian, and he'll take your questions. You come back, Craig, with the contradiction.
I did the Bible, whether it's thing I'm born Catholic.
Come and bring them back. But thank you for your questions, Craig. I really do appreciate it.
I really do appreciate your time. Would you take one of them?
No.
Okay. Read it. Do you know Charles Spurgeon once said, there's enough dust on a person's Bible to write hell. I hope that's not your case. Please wipe the dust off your Bibles and read it. God bless you, and I'm going to pass over to the next team.